what in certain cases if you want your end users to update the templates just before generating it. Of course, you cannot just update the template in the setup screen. So you might want to give him the template and say, make your changes, but be careful for these merge fields. In this case, I just want to add a big fat text to it, like this one. This is the locally updated document. Okay, so this is my document that I now have updated, and actually I want to use this document to be used in PDF Butler to generate my PDF, and not any of these documents that are attached to the configuration. So I want to override the configuration with a local document. Okay, that's perfectly possible. How do we go about that? Step one is ask our support department for the add-on .config override. It's a free add-on, so you just have to install it, and then it's there and you can use it. Next up, when this add-on is installed, you can just change the permission sets. Make sure the record type .config override is available and that all the fields have edit rights. So, of course, for an end user, this is the admin permission set. For the user permission set, you can make sure that they have read access on all of the fields. So any of the override fields that are specifically added for this functionality, make sure that these are checked. Okay, so permissions done, installation of the package done. Now we can continue to configure our setup. To do that, of course, we're going to create, as always in PDF Butter, an actionable. And for this case, I've selected to have the actionable linked to a pack and not directly to the .config. Both are possible, but in this case, like I said, I just want to run the pack and maybe I want to run the .config separately without doing the override. I already created the pack. It's called Get Local Template. You can choose the name. It's linked, of course, to our quote .config, as you would expect, and it has an actionable. If we go and look in this actionable, then you can see that it's of the record type .config override, and it uses the class that's added in the add-on package, and this is the name of the class. The name of the class will also be on our Academy and in our YouTube video, so you can easily copy-paste it from there. It's a before actionable, it's active, of course, and as seen, it's linked to the pack. So to configure this specific setup, what you have to do is just add which .config you actually want to override. This means that in a certain setup, you might have main .configs and template.configs, so you can actually override both. If in a certain case you want to override a template that's being dynamically loaded into your document, then you can just say, hey, I want to override this template with a document that's located on my system. So you can just choose which .config to override. And if you want to override multiple documents, the only thing you have to do is actually add multiple actionables like this one, and it will add every document to override. Next up, we have to choose which document we're going to use as the override document. For this, you can just enter a name of a file that's linked to your record. And of course, you can use wildcards. So if you say, okay, it always has to end with a local template, but the beginning of the name of the document, you can select that. That's not a problem. So you can just do that right here with the percent sign. Now, okay, what I've done is on my opportunity, I have added my local file, as you can see, just drag and dropped it on here, and I called it my local opportunity. So, my local template. So, local template is the end name of my the title of my file, and so it will use the percents to figure out the my itself. As you can see, the big red text is right here. So this is actually what I would like to see when I generate my document. Everything is set. Our actionable is active. Our configuration is done. Everything is there. So let's take a look how this would work how this will actually work. So I have my pack configured here, But let's take a look at how it would work without the actionable to override it. So for that, I can just run the quote separately as a .config without the actionable that will choose the override template. And if I run this one, as you can see, it doesn't have the big red text. So this one is perfect. And this is taking the template from our from our configuration over here. Now, what we of course want to see is the actionable. And this one is the pack linked with the actionable. And if I run this one, you would see that it now has the big red text like in our override template. So this is how you can just do override templates with PDF Butler. Thank you very much.